Yo, what is poppin', ladies and gents? I am back here again with another Unordinary Reaction, episode 194. You already know what it is. And before we start this video, you already know this video is sponsored by nobody. I really just looked to my left and my right like, oh my god, who is it? And then I just slapped y'all with the haha. Y'all really would have thought, man, I should be sponsored, bro. Why ain't I sponsored, bro? I be doing all these webtoon videos. That's cap. That's really cap. I really cap in heart, but like, nah. If you really watch my videos, if you're really down for me, bro, if you really like my content, you'll do me a favor and check out my two recent videos. One about the Grim Reaper and the other one about a webtoon called Omnipotent Reader. Oh my god, my throat just threw out for a second. But like, yes sir. Let's hop right into this. Episode 194. You already know what we're doing. Serafino! Okay. Oh, hey, Blake. Damn, it didn't work out with Remy. Now he pulling up on Sarah. Crazy things. You really would have thought your own boy. But nah. They really be lying to your face. How's it going? Pretty good. You're heading to class now? That's what they all say when they try to flirt. Nah, I was about to go work out. Okay. Typical Atlanta to, like, turn somebody down. More flyers? Didn't we take care of those already? Yeah, but someone's been taking them down. Shout out to John. Really? That's weird. So I've been replacing them during my free blocks. I'm off to hang some up now, actually. Well, I've got some time too. Need some help? Aw, sure. Thanks, Serafina. You got it. Episode 194. And then you already know I had the whole episode correct and all that stuff. This one's missing some flyers. Huh. Well, look who it is, Cripple Serafina. So you've been the one undoing all of our work. Wait, shouldn't it be the other way around? Y'all the one undoing her work? Bro, I should smack the shit out of you. Figures, only weaklings would care about the safe house. Bro, why one of y'all look like a girl and the other one look like you got a bowl cut? Don't let me smack the shit out of you and step on you with my Timbs, bro. Hey, take those posters down or you'll be sorry. I'll smack the shit out of you. So it's always the weakest guys, bro. It's always the weakest guys. Are you listening? Don't ignore us. Bro. She really about to smack you. If you have a problem with the safe house, then don't come. Why should I remove my flyers just for you? Huh. Well, what will have you know? We're under the orders of the new king. You know your friend John? Bro, why does guy look like that? Look at his freaking eyes. He looked like a dirty, disgusting pedophile. Like, actually, bro. Oh gosh, there's a freaking fly on my screen. There's a whole fly on my screen for a second. He wants everything taken down. So I'm afraid you don't have a choice. Bro, I don't know why, where the hell the damn fly came from. John again? Bro, it's back. Where's my pit? Bro, why are you flying on my shit? Bro, get off my screen, bro. Get off my screen, bro. I just hit that shit with a piece of paper. Now he in the garbage. You know how we do. If I want you there, I'm tossing you in the garbage. John again? You think dropping his name is gonna change my mind? Yeah, stay your ground, bro. Stay your ground. I ain't a fan of no damn weaklings. If you're gonna get beat up, you better try to fight back. Hey, quit acting all tough, Serafina. You're completely defenseless. Bro, half y'all can't even fight. You're so reliant on your abilities that you talk all this shit, then you get smacked. Take down your posters now. No. What you gonna do about it? Look at these guys. How dare you? We warned you, idiot. As I thought. They're not much faster than I am. I can hold them off. Ooh, yo, this reminds me of that, the time when John did the same shit. He tossed all these freaking things in their face and then he grabbed one of them. Where'd she go? Ooh, smash. Bro, she really just hit this man with the whole Beerus chop to the neck when, if y'all watch Dragon Ball Super, when Beerus fight in Goku and Super Saiyan 3 on, what's his name? This is goddamn King Kai's planet. Smack, when he hit him in the back of the throat. Well, he didn't hit him on the back of the throat. He actually put his hand on his shoulder, but yeah, that's literally what just happened here. Bro, she looked like she got an eye patch. Smashed, bro. This is like freaking a flashback to the Blake's fight, except you're just like replacing it with Serafina in each panel. Well, that's one guy down. Don't get cocky. Don't act all tough, bro. You know for a fact the green guy was stronger than you. That's why he went in first. Is that all you've got? Ooh, parry. Ooh, about to kick. Yes, sir. Lose that balance. Another elbow. Hit him with the same move. Bro, Serafina's like those guys, right? When you're playing basketball or you're playing a sport, they literally tell you what they're about to do, but you still can't stop them. That's literally what just happened. Because she said the same. She did the same thing pretty much twice. Smashed. How long has it been since I've won a match like this? By the way, she's talking about how she's overpowered an opponent. I can't help but miss this feeling. What do we have here? Oh, Zeke. Oh, wow. Yo, I'm gonna tell y'all right now. You know how Zeke punched her in the stomach? I know how like her and John are in a fight right now. But I'm gonna tell y'all right now. If John saw that, he probably would have smacked the shit out of Zeke. I ain't gonna cap. Even right now, he probably still would have felt some type of way about that. But I'm just saying the truth. Cough, cough, cough. Zeke. Man, look who it is. It's the suck up. Hey, Serafina. You got some nerve fighting back against my guys. Why do you always hang out on? Why do you always hang around the weakest guys, bro? It's always the weakest guys crowding around that one guy. It's like, man, he's like number what, 7 on the list? Number 6? I don't even know. And everybody crowding around him. Bro, you're not even top 5. Get out of here. Not to mention, you defied the king too. Ugh. It's time a cripple like you learned how this hierarchy works. Bro, you talking all this shit when John did the same thing to you and he was a cripple. When he was playing cripple, you really are like repeating the same mistakes. Serafina about to pull back up with her powers, right? And then you're gonna be cowering underneath the stairs with all the freaking bugs and shit. And then you're gonna be like, oh my god, Serafina, my bad. You know, I had to do what I had to do. Then he's gonna smack the shit out of you and stuff you in a locker, bro. And then you're gonna be like, yo, what did I do to deserve this? Next thing you know, he's gonna pull up on her, bringing her cans of coffee and then having that shit all over his freaking head and stuff. There's nothing here to help you. There's nobody here to help you, my bad. You won't get away from me this time. Wait, what? What do you mean this time? Oh, right. So you already did this shit twice, I think. Zeke, you snake. Let me go. Oh, come on now. Be careful what you say to Miss Serafina. You're at my mercy. Shut up. Yo! She just smashed his cojones, bro. She just said, yo. You like nutcrackers? You like Christmas? Let me hit you with that shit. So. Bro. He really got the pout face on right now. Or at least... Shit, yo, so you're trying to tell me, man, bro, you goofy as shit for that, bro. Serafina, you get back here. Bro, ooh, she flipping over freaking steps and shit. How you run so fast in a uniform, bro? Like, especially with shoes. I never understood how they run so fast in freaking shoes. Like, bro, I know for a fact them shits don't got no grip. If Zeke catches me here, I'm done for. The only chance I have is to find a classroom and hide. Bro, look at this face. Bro. Bump. Ooh, shout out to Blake. What's going on? I heard yelling from this direction. Zeke's after me. Huh? Why? You've got to be kidding. Psh, asshole. Oh, Blake. Zeke, back off, moron. What a surprise to see you here. Listen, I'm going to need you to step aside. Or what? Or you'll suffer severe consequences. You see, I'm under direct orders from the new king. If he finds out that you went against me, he'll take it as a personal attack. It's treason. Shut the hell up, you acting like this shit a whole country, bro. Yo, you best believe. Yo, Zeke, you lucky I'm not in this story, bro. I really would have put on the Timbs and stomped you out. Treason? Are you serious? Who the hell do you think you are? Like I care. Go report to the new king then. Yeah. And while you're at it, tell him to go fuck himself. Yo, this shit is goofy as shit, bro. Alright, so. Let's talk about this chapter right away. You know, nothing really was accomplished. Literally nothing was accomplished this entire chapter. But I know where Uruchan's going with this. She's pretty much using this as a chapter to build up Blake's character development. And I've talked about this. I talked about this in my other recent video with the whole routes thing. I was like, we're gonna get into a whole Blake situation soon. I'm just gonna tell y'all right now, we are gonna get into an opportunity. We're gonna get into a character arc where Blake is going to be the main focus. We've gotten those mini arcs where like those episodes where it's like it's just Blake and like he's like training and stuff. I'm just gonna let y'all know. We already know for a fact that Blake and Zeke are gonna fight next episode. So there's that. Who do I think is gonna win? Bro. So Zeke, last time I remember, was a 4.2. But ever since that episode where Blake did that whole, oh my god, Super Saiyan God pulse bullshit, then at that point Zeke was already a, I mean not Zeke, freaking Blake was already a five, and I've been preaching this shit since like that whole pulse thing when he caught Remy. So yes, I do think he is a five, at least, at the very least. He's either a five to a 5.5. He's somewhere around there. That's my guess anyway. And I've been saying this, and if you don't believe me, I don't give a shit, because I did say it, and I can find one of these videos, but I'm not about to go back right now and do that. But yes, I do think, Blake is somewhere around there, just because he does have a passive right now. I don't know exactly what the hell to call it, but he does definitely have a passive now, and we're just waiting for that time to come. So yes, Zeke is probably going to fight Blake next episode. I think Blake's obviously going to win. He's about to let this man know that life is not what it seems. He's really about to show him. But do I think Blake, even after training, could beat John? Hell no. Are you crazy? You just copy the same. He's just gonna copy the ability and use it. Use the same shit. It's like, it doesn't really matter too much to me, to be honest. Because like, especially if like, if they're not even in hand-to-hand combat. We already saw that John's better at hand-to-hand combat. But Blake, I'm not gonna say he's like trash or nothing. Nah, he could throw hands. He could definitely throw hands. He's definitely on the top three list when it comes to throwing hands in the school. Not gonna cap about that. He definitely is. Cause like, you know. He was definitely throwing hands, I won't lie. This episode, you know, nothing was really accomplished. Nothing, like, it didn't add to the story depth or anything. It didn't, like, oh my god, blockbuster. Nah. It just, like, you know, it was just a build-up for character development. So, do I think the episode was bad? No, I don't think it was bad. I think it was, like, a 6 or a 7. It was pretty average, a little bit above average, because it's building up to something. That's the thing when I say with this whole filler arc. When I said it was a filler arc, it is a filler arc, but it's also a build-up arc. So, like, you just gotta, like, differentiate. Some of the chapters are definitely gonna be fillers like this, and some of them are also gonna be build-ups, like, or leading into build-ups. So that's the one thing I do wanna, exaggerate, I guess is the best way to put it. Like, put it in quotes, just like, yes, sir, there is going to be a lot of development in the future from this. I do expect a lot from Blake in the future. Right now, a lot of people are like, yo, why you keep justifying John's behavior? And wait, hold the hell up, bro. That's, I need to get into that. I've been saying this, that I justified his behavior with the whole hierarchy thing, but I've been commenting on the people's video comments, like, it's justifiable what he did with the hierarchy, but like, now he's definitely a hypocrite. 100%. I like John, he's my favorite character. But all bias aside, because you can't be biased when you're doing this thing. You can't be like, you know, oh my god, I can't be blinded by this bullshit. No, I can't. Right now, John is definitely in the wrong. He has his reasons. Yes. Are all of them valid? Definitely not. Right now, what are you doing with the whole school? Just trying to leave it in shambles? That's definitely not wavy, bro. You trying to tell me you pointed out everything that was wrong with the school and now you don't want to do nothing? Come on, that's literally a repeat of the mistake. Where the hell is my water? My voice getting dry as shit right now. I know some of y'all be coming for the ASMR. Don't think y'all be hiding. I know where you are. I know you in the comment section. I know you in the viewer circle. But yes, I do think, I think this episode was pretty decent, I guess. It was just pretty much a semi-fight. You know, it was kind of cool seeing Seraphina back in action. All that extra stuff. I do think she's going to get her powers back eventually. Like, after, like, maybe next year. I'm going to say next year. Probably. That's just gonna be an assumption. I think she's gonna get it back in either two ways. I said this in my video. Either one, Layla's gonna pull up, you know, she's gonna get an antidote, we're gonna learn some stuff. Or two, Seraphina's gonna be put in some crazy situation, like, oh my god, I'm tired of not having my powers, and then it's gonna blow up and you know, it's gonna come back. It's gonna just come back to her, like, out of nowhere. Like, pretty much, like, the compromise status is just gonna turn to, like, yes, this cannot hold me back. Some shit like that. But that is just how I think the episode went and how I think the future will go. If you guys like this format a little bit more about me just like reviewing the chapter, doing my commentary, and then talking about my thoughts at the end, then just let me know and I'll do this more often, because I do be having things to say at the end. But also check out the last two videos that I posted. I'm really trying to get to like at least 1700 subscribers by the end of the week, so hopefully you guys can get me there. I was trying to get to 1800 before the end of the summer for me, but you know, it's not out of the question. We got about a week, so hopefully y'all enjoy. Don't forget to like and subscribe, comment down below, check out my videos, all the extra stuff. Peace out.